In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. The tragic death of Eoghan-Rua has shocked and saddened us all. But we are not without help. We are not without hope. God is with us, and we turn to him now in this, the funeral mass for Eoghan-Rua. Out of the depths we cry to you, O Lord, Lord of mercy. Our souls are waiting for you. We are counting on your word. Christ, have mercy. With you there is mercy and fullness of redemption. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Eoghan-Rua, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Now we'll all be seated and we'll listen to the word of God proclaimed in the readings by Sean and Margaret.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I'm going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal clashing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. The word of the Lord.
The Lord's my shepherd, I am not alone. He leads me along in pastures green. He leads me by the still, still waters. His goodness restores my soul, and I will trust in you alone, and I will trust in you alone, for your grace.
Reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. For everything there is a reason, and for the time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up what has been planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to seek, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to throw away. A time to tear, and a time to sow. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We stand to acclaim the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know, even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you." "Your brother," said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know he will rise again at the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said. "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who was to come into this world." The Gospel of the Lord. Now, before I say anything more, we have a beautiful photograph of Eoghan-Rua here in front of us, but it wouldn't be complete without a couple of other items that have to be to come up in procession. Is there anybody going to take them? Good man. Because there's a Dublin football jersey, we'll explain that a bit more later, and there's the famous cap, his black flat cap, and it reminds me of the play about Harry Flynn. One of the recurring lines in that is, "Where's me cap?" But the cap's coming up now. Three wise men to carry them up, too. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. There are occasions in life and death which make us cry out, why? And Eoghan-Rua's death is one such occasion. And over and above the grief which we feel on the death of any loved one, there is the extra and anguish question, why did it have to happen? And in addition to our desolation, we feel in some way let down by the God whom we have learned from childhood to call our Father. Now, all down the ages, believers have cried out to God, why? Why have you allowed this to happen? Why have you done this to us? And the Psalms are full of cries like these. It's important to speak our real feelings to God. Yes, he knows them already, but he also knows our need to express them. His own son, Jesus, was forced to cry out to him, why have you abandoned me? And that cry is part of the mystery of life, the mystery of faith itself. Our Father in heaven, as he listens with utmost compassion to our cry, quietly asks us to believe in and trust him. He does not send these crosses to pin us to the ground, to paralyze us. They come to us as they come to God's own Son from the conditions of life in this world. And they come to us unbidden and unwanted as occasions for deep and anguished faith. God does not explain why these demands are made of us. And I suppose even if he did, we probably wouldn't be in a state of mind to understand anyway. Such answers belong to the end of time, when earth and sea will have yielded up their dead, when there will be no more pain or sorrow, when God will wipe away all tears. But in the meantime, he asks us to offer him the weight of our grief and the sacrifice of our tears. And he will support us. He asks us for faith and trust at the very moment when we feel we have none to offer him. For he is never nearer than when we are drained of all feeling and incapable of seeing clearly enough to even pray. It is when we feel that we have nothing else left to offer him but our emptiness and our desolation that he is nearest to us. God's purposes are being slowly and painfully worked out in this world of ours in ways which surpass our understanding. He does not will an early or a tragic death, but such deaths happen in the world that he is creating. And when they do, he is there with his plea that we should love and trust him, that we should let go and let God be God. Memory is powerful. And God calls us to remember. And he's calling us today and for all the future to remember Eoghan-Rua for who he was. He was a young man with a wise old head on him. And he was proud to be Irish. He loved the land, the moods of the countryside, in accordance with the seasons, its sounds and its smells. And above all, he loved its people, their music and their song and their conversation. And there was something about horses that Eoghan-Rua had an affinity with. And I wonder, did he ever see the film The Horse Whisperer? For I'm sure he would have thoroughly enjoyed it. He had a talent for sales, I'm told, and I heard it said at the wake that, wait till you hear this, that he could sell snow to Eskimos and buy it back half price. Quote, unquote. He wasn't involved in sport in any way, not sporty, but he followed Dublin GAA and would proudly have worn that jersey. And as you can see, it's not far away from us. By the way, Father Sheehan is a dyed-in-the-wool Kerry man, as his name might suggest. And if he was here this morning seeing that jersey, he might say, as Kerry men have often said before, we'll flush the jacks. Although Eoghan-Rua will always be with us in spirit, he cannot defend himself from the charge that I heard yesterday, that he was a mammy's boy. And there is no doubt that he loved his mother and would do anything for her. And that relationship naturally was mutual. God watched his son die in agony of mind and body, so that we might know that he knows from the inside what it means to suffer, to grieve, and to experience the deepest desolation. We are all part of the mystery of God's creation and of his purposes. Our faith tells us that in spite of the darkness we are sometimes called upon to enter on our journey through life, the road will end in the triumph of light and joy and the final meaning of it all. I extend my sympathy, that of Father Sheehan, and also the sympathy of the Jesuit fathers, Brendan and Frank, to Cathleen and to her family, Bernard, Leona, Gerard, Emma, Alison, Sarah-Louise and Martin-Leo, and also to Eoghan-Rua's nieces and nephews, and all the family and friends. And may he rest in peace. Amen. And now we will be led in prayer by Molly, Anya, Antoinette, and then there's a change. I think it's Rosie is also going to lead us. God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people, both living and dead.
The Christ to whom honor was united in baptism, may he welcome him into heaven and give him his share in glory. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the family, relatives and friends of Eoghan-Rua, that they may find comfort in their faith in God and strength through the support of the community. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Family and friends of Eoghan-Rua seek comfort and consolation, heal their pain and their dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, graciously hear us. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
We offer this
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we humbly present you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Eoghan-Rua, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful Judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life has changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy,
holy,
holy.
Gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ our Lord will come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, And as we look forward to a second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, our venerable spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Eamon, our Bishop, his assistant Bishop Michael, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Eoghan-Rua, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now we stand, and at the Saviour's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Now, for the distribution of Holy Communion, I will distribute communion to those on my right hand, middle aisle. If you come up the center aisle, go back to your seats by the side aisle. And meanwhile, Eamon will distribute to those on my left hand, middle aisle. Similarly, come up the center and down the sides. And when we have finished, then Eamon will move over to the station to the cross side, and I will move over to the other side. So we'll just take our time and we'll get there all right. The body of Christ.
Keep us safe to Mary.
just before the commendation. Sharon and Sarah-Louise are going to offer us a couple of nicely chosen reflections.
You give no one a last farewell, nor even say goodbye. You were gone before we knew it, and only God knows why. A million times we'll miss you, a million times we'll cry. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. In life we loved you dearly, in death we love you still. In our hearts you hold a place that no one else can fill. It broke our hearts to lose you, but you didn't go alone. For part of us went with you the day God took you home. We'll meet again someday, I know, in a better place. I thank God he made you my brother when you were here on earth.
A letter from heaven. To my dearest family, some things I'd like to say. But first of all, to let you know that I have arrived okay. I'm writing this from heaven. Here I dwell with God above. Here there's no more tears of sadness. Here is just eternal love. Please do not be unhappy just because I am out of sight. Remember that I am with you every morning, noon, and night. That day I had to leave you when my life on earth was through, God picked me up and hugged me, and he said, I welcome you. It's good to have you back again. You were missed while you were gone. As for your dearest family, they'll be here later on. I need you here so badly. You are part of my plan. There is so much that we can do to help our mortal man. God gave me a list of things that he wished for me to do, and foremost on the list was to watch and care for you. And when you lie in bed at night, the day chores put to flight, God and I are closest to you in the middle of the night. When you think of my life on earth and all those loving years, because you are only human, they are bound to bring you tears. But do not be afraid to cry. It does relieve the pain. Remember, there would be no flowers unless there was some rain. I wish that I could tell you all that God has planned, but if I were to tell you, you wouldn't understand. But one thing is for certain, though my life on earth is over, I'm closer to you now than I ever was before. There are rocky roads ahead of you and many hills to climb. But together we can do it by taking one day at a time. When you're walking down the street and you've got me on my mind, I'm walking in your footsteps, only a half step behind. And when it's time for you to go from that body to be free, remember you're not going, you're coming here to me. Eoghan-Rua, may your beautiful and kind and gentle soul rest in peace.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Eoghan-Rua may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And before the final commendation, I would like to thank all who have helped over these last few days visiting the wake and supporting the family and preparing the liturgy here this morning. And I'd like to thank particularly Father Brendan, who was there at the time, was able to console the family at that early stage. And I'd like to thank Father Sheehan, who arranged with the family, the readings, etc. And for those who did the readings and the prayers, as you can see, it doesn't be easy. It doesn't be easy, but there is a grace in that. There is a grace and a blessing in that. And I'd like to thank Francis for keeping us all in the straight and narrow and for reminding me about the missing items that didn't come up at the start, but they certainly made their presence felt. And to the three wise men who were well capable of bringing them up. And I'd like to thank Sinead for the lovely singing. Did you see Sinead? Yeah? I was just going to say, did you see Sinead on the television the other night? She was on BBC Two telling us all how good it is to be drinking tea. Now, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Eoghan-Rua, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.